Hello, welcome to another Week in Review. I'm Scott Douglas.
I'm Ian Holiday.
I'm Igor. How are you?
And welcome back, you two. I know we had a few weeks hiatus due to the holidays. We had Christmas.
So one week hiatus.
No, we had Christmas, we had New Year's, and...
I don't know. No, I was on vacation. My mind was on vacation,
too. We didn't see each other
too.
For a long time.
Yeah.
Which is probably why we're smiling.
I'm not complaining about that one bit.
Yeah, give us a few more hours, then you'll see our true colors. So it was a big week in Western New York as Buffalo hosted the World Junior Hockey Championship. Is that what the official name was, Ian?
I don't know the official name of it. I just know that there are a lot of hockey players from all over the world.
Yeah, teams from all over the world came to Buffalo to compete at the arena. And a lot of people were hoping that Canada and the United States would make it to the finals. And they almost did.
Almost.
It was almost a repeat of the Winter Olympics last year. But the United States took the bronze and Canada went on to play Russia in the finals. And I guess they were pretty confident, too. You know, Canada, that's their thing.
Yeah.
Hockey. No other country's supposed to have this. Right?
I didn't know we played hockey. I thought it was only a Canada thing.
But... Well, yeah, they're branching out. It was a world tournament.
All right, so what?
Don't you have a grandmother who lives in Canada?
Yeah, that's why I know about hockey. I thought that they pay attention to that. It's not my thing. I don't know.
So the big finale was this past weekend, and Russia actually came out on top and beat the Canadians. Whooped them in the third period.
Yeah, they had it coming. They're so smug up
but,
there.
But the best part of the story was that the Russians had to catch a 6 a.m. flight the next day to get back to Russia. I mean, we got them here. They did their thing. Now we kick them back out. It's the American way.
But they didn't quite make their flight.
No, because once you win a big championship, what would you do, Igor?
Probably get a bunch of hookers and celebrate it up big time style.
That sounds about right. And I think the Russians did. But the only problem was that this is the World Junior Hockey Championship, which junior and means
no hookers.
Younger than 21.
That's right. And the legal drinking age in the United States is 21. And these Russians, I guess they went out and they lived it all. They got plastered.
Well, too drunk to get on the plane.
Well, the Russians, aren't they known for vodka drinking?
You think so? You think they can handle their alcohol?
Because I thought they started them young in Russia.
Well, I think they do. I don't even know what the legal age is over there.
Do they even have one?
So they couldn't get on the plane.
No, well, some of them did. And I guess they had to bring one of the kids up in a wheelchair because he couldn't walk
to
the plane. And they kicked everybody off.
No, that's a party right there when you can't even walk. You got to wheel you to the plane.
Yeah, I know. And I can't figure out why they would book a 6 a.m. flight the next day.
It's Russia.
Maybe they got confused. They were looking at, Russian time.
No, they're looking at, it's 8 o'clock at night. This is beautiful.
Yeah, and it turned out the conversion didn't quite make it over in the online purchasing, I think, maybe.
That must be it. That's all I can figure.
Yeah, I think we need to fire their travel agent.
I think
whoever set
too.
That one up there. But I guess they finally make it back, because I know they were in line this morning. I've seen them on the news.
I think they're gone.
They're back.
They're on their way back to Russia.
So was anybody in trouble over this, or was it just kind of funny story? Ha ha, we couldn't make
our
flight.
Well, the problem is, where did they get the alcohol?
Right.
Because they were staying at, was it the Adams Mark Hotel?
I think
it was the Adams Mark Hotel up in Buffalo. And there's video and pictures out now, them down in the bar, boozing it up. And if they're all under 21, I think the hotel bar is going to be in a little bit of trouble.
The investigation continues.
Because I was thinking maybe it was like their coach or something like that that said, don't worry about it. I'm just going to supply you the alcohol and it'll go through me. So even though they just won a championship, I wonder if the management will get canned because of this. Or
I mean, you can get fined. I mean, what I don't understand, the legal drinking age over in Russia is, it's probably 12. 14, 12. I don't know. They put a little vodka in the bottle. They start you early. And you kind of feel bad for them, too, because, a lot of people, especially around here, when they turn 19, where's the first place they go? Ontario. They go over to Canada. Because the legal drinking age is 19, then they got to come back to the States and it's 21. You got to wait another 2 years.
Yeah, just like when I was a kid, way back when the legal drinking age in Pennsylvania was 21, it was 18 in New York.
Oh, really? So you guys just hop across the border.
Nice.
Wow.
Yeah.
How convenient, huh?
Yeah.
Until you got to drive back 219 to get across that state border.
Yep.
And the cops are there waiting for you.
Exactly.
So this is a good old time. That's back in the bootlegging days, wasn't it?
It was.
I don't even remember. I can't remember when the drinking age was 18. Do you?
I heard about it when I was, I guess in the early 80s, late 70s.
Yes, early 80s.
It was also in Ohio where my family's from, and my dad was telling me about all the shenanigans that they got into in high school. legal.
Yes.
So, yeah.
I was in college when it switched. I was already 21.
That's got to be the worst feeling in the world. Can you imagine, you know, you're 17, your birthday's coming up in a couple weeks, and then the government changes the law.
Well, what happens if you're already made it there and you've been drinking for a year, and then they take it away from you?
Well, yeah, I guess it'd have to be a there's no grandfather clause or something like that.
Yeah, so if you're like, it was too long ago.
Yeah, if you're 19, you're drinking it up. It was legal at 18, and then all of a sudden, oh, you can't drink for another 2 years. Oh, well, great. I can go fight in a war, but I can't drink alcohol. Exactly. That's terrific.
That's been the argument for decades now, Igor. So that's pretty much the big story of the week. I know coming up next week, we're going to have a special announcement. We got a nice little contest coming up with one of the three of us here, and it's actually right up that person's alley. We'll spill all the details for you next week. We have our company Christmas party. I've been calling it the Polish Christmas party since 2 weeks after Christmas.
I'm Polish. What do you got against Polish?
Well, so am I, too.
What are you saying, that we can't keep time, or that we don't do things traditionally in your frame of time?
January 7th.
That's close enough to Christmas.
It's
right?
our New Year's party. We'll go with that one here. So I'm sure we'll have some interesting stories. And please leave your camera at the station.
Yeah, we gotta bring
the
camera.
No, don't bring the camera. No, come on, because it's embarrassing.
Well, if she doesn't bring her camera, I'm gonna bring mine, because there's gonna be some shenanigans, and I'm gonna have some video footage. So tune in next week for some embarrassing video. I'm sure.
I take my camera everywhere. So
good. Then we're all in for a treat. Be sure you get that. Get the largest free drink that you can.
I will definitely get a nice Long Island iced tea.
One free drink, and I'm going to make it worth my while.
All right, so have a great week, everybody. For next time, I'm Scott Douglas for Ann Holiday and the one and only
Igor.
We'll see you next week.